You're probably going to have, let's say, 10,000 alarms coming in a day. And do you really need to see a door force alarm or a door help alarm here? If you really need to tell you where your problems are, is your panel offline at a substation where people, you know, they can't access that substation at a specific time of the day to fix something, then not only is your critical infrastructure going to be down, but they could be letting fines and things like that. So I think making the system work for you, not only that, but if people haven't used their car for a certain amount of time, is that system logically telling you that, all right, this has happened, and either you need to make a decision on it or the system's going to make that decision for you. So I think, you know, getting analytics built in, it's not really what you put in your technology anymore. It's what the technology is going to tell you is going on. Correct. You still need to work there, right? If they were a contractor, when they were supposed to be there, so I think that's one of the biggest aspects of managing critical infrastructure, so it actually has access. And then, you know, if you think about inside of that, we want to be on top of the, you know, concerns and trying to be more and probably forever and beyond. It's that the right person has access to the right areas. No longer is, you know, it's no longer that you can just give somebody blanket access across your entire infrastructure. You have to truly belong there. You have to truly belong there to be that. I think if you look in the past, obviously you look up and see power lines and you see you think critical infrastructure as kind of being things that we've known from way back, you know, power, energy, oil, you know, things like that. Nowadays you're thinking more, you know, data center providers. Imagine, you know, if a data center provider has probably got all of the Fortune 500 companies' data housed in those facilities, as well as anything that's housing kind of cybersecurity nowadays. I mean, we've seen, you know, large companies held for ransom, small companies just left to where they can't even operate because their critical infrastructure has been, has been compromised.